Even before you go in, the gin mill stands out, looking like something from the 1930s. Owner Josh Irby opened the business Black Friday after a successful career as a head chef.
This is the kitchen. You want to be able to expand your own creative ability without having limitations from other people's idea of success.
The eating area has plenty of room and a distinct decor.
We have a mezzanine level up top that seats anywhere from 30 to 45 probably, and the entire building seats 128.
The kitchen is tight quarters, but with an attention to detail on the food.
Chilean sea bass here.
Cut fresh and cooked in 6-ounce chunks before it's crusted to serve.
Chilean sea bass. Man, it's fabulous.
Also, USDA choice ribeyes, as large as 16 ounces. Irby invested in an iron-grated grill just for his steak.
It's right here, heats up to 1,800 degrees. I mean, literally, I can season the steaks, put them in there, and I can almost watch the salt melt.
The unique menu is, you know, what brings everybody in.
She recommends the smoked duck bacon pizza. Irby handpicked his staff and the bar, which he bought because of its history.
That bar is from Baltimore, Maryland. It was made in 1888. We're actually working with the guy that we purchased it from because he has pictures of Teddy Roosevelt and William Howard Taft sitting at that bar.
When we step into the gin mill, it is a bit like stepping back in time with the history of this bar. So pour it again, Sam.
My pleasure.
The gin mill, already proving to be a cut above the rest.